revelation of who God is, then my coming has been in vain. I need a fresh revelation every day. I got to go to work tomorrow. I need a fresh revelation. I got to go to the courthouse this week. I need a fresh revelation. I got to go to the hospital this week. I need a fresh revelation. I got to go down to the police precinct again. I need a fresh revelation. They told me I had breast cancer. I need a fresh revelation. They told me I had prostate cancer. I need a fresh revelation. My wife told me she don't love me. I need a fresh revelation. My husband walked out on me. I need a fresh revelation. I got a pizza at the job. I need a fresh revelation. Tell somebody, I need a fresh revelation.
I need a fresh revelation.
What does that mean? That means I need to see things this year that I've never seen before. God is going to show me some things that my mind could not conceive. This year, God is going to speak things into my ear that I've never heard. I'm going to see and hear things that I didn't hear before because of distraction.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
But as soon as God moves the distraction, I saw God. When God moved the distraction, I saw him clearly. I thought I saw him some time before, but I had things and people and mindsets and attitude in front of me. But God said, this year, I'm moving your distraction because you got to see me. You've seen everybody else. You heard everybody else. But this year, you need to hear me.
Yes.
When you hear me this year, I'm going to give you specific instructions. I'm going to tell you where to go. I'm going to tell you where to go. I'm going to tell you who to see when you get there. I'm going to show you stuff. I'm going to blow your mind. I'm going to turn you inside out. I'm going to turn you upside down. I'm going to turn your life around. And so to do it, I had to kill off some folk and get rid of some folk.
Yes.
Move folk out the way. Move every one of your crutches. Why? Because I need you to be receiving fresh revelation. Watch this. Jesus said, daily bread.
Daily?
Daily bread I need. The problem with most of us is we're too busy living on information. But this year, God wants you living on revelation.
Yes.
Yeah. Some of your information is wrong. But I bet you if you get revelation, the revelation from God is never wrong. I tell somebody, I'm living on revelation this year. I may not have all the info. Some of the info may be wrong. Some of the info may be false. Some of the info may not be all correct. But every word of God is true. Let man be a liar, but let every word of God be true. And I thank God for it because none of his word shall return void.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
When Isaiah, got into the presence of God,
thank you, Jesus.
He said,
thank you, Lord.
Woe is me.
Yes,
uh-huh.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Woe is me.
Uh-huh.
In God's, get this, in God's holiness, I got a woe-ness.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I realize in God's presence that I'm really messed up.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
I realize in God's presence that I ain't nothing and nobody.
Thank you.
I realize when I got into God's presence that my mouth is really nasty. When I got into God's presence, I realized that my temper is really, really short. When I got into God's presence, I realized that some of the things I'm thinking is not exactly godly. When I got into God's presence, I realized that I'm defected and defective and messed up in his presence. I don't know if you've ever been really in God's presence, because when you get in his presence, you realize how small you are, how insignificant you are. I don't care how many licenses you got. When you're in God's presence, you ain't nothing. I don't care if I ever make anything in this church. If I make bishop or whatever, it don't matter to God. If they change my shirt and change my cause, it don't mean nothing to God. Because when I get in his presence, when I die and go to heaven, I may not sit in bishops one way, pastors another way, state mamas this way, elders are going this way. No. When I get into God's presence, when I die and go to heaven, I'm just going to be so glad to be there. I'm going to run down to the throne and say, God, it wasn't about me at all. It wasn't about my title.
All right.
It wasn't about my credentials. It wasn't about my position. mess up. God, I need your help. Is there anybody here who came tonight and you know you need God's help? You know if it had not been for God who is on your side, you would have broke up. You would have been suicidal. You would have walked off and left everything. If it had not been for God, you would be in a hospital not knowing who you are, not knowing your name. If it had not been for God, your marriage would have fell apart. I ain't got no business. I messed up because sometimes I do think that it's all about me. Sometimes I think that I'm all of that in a bag of chips and a lemon with some twists and some lime in it. Sometimes I think that about myself. But every now and then I gotta say, Harley, bring yourself down. I gotta tell my flesh back up a little bit. Because if it was not for God, you wouldn't be where you are. If it was not for God, you wouldn't have a job. If it was not for God, you wouldn't have your right mind. If it wasn't for God, you wouldn't have the car you drive. If it wasn't for God, you wouldn't know the difference between your left hand or your right foot. If it was not for God, tell somebody, if it wasn't for God,
if it wasn't for God, if it wasn't for God, glory to God. Glory. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every now and then, God demands that you do self-assessment.
Yes.
Sometimes you need to look in the mirror and talk to yourself.
Yes, you do.
Sometimes you need to look in the mirror and say, look at here, you ain't nothing, you ain't nobody, and if it wasn't for God, you wouldn't be where you are right now. Sometimes you better talk to yourself.
Oh, yeah,
because you know what? Don't blow your head up.
Oh, yes,
don't make you think you all of that. Uh-huh. Don't make you think you good. You know what? I found this out about church folk. The same folk who are crying Hosanna today, give them a few more days, and they'll be crying, crucify him.
Yes, they will. Yes, they will. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
The same folk.
Same folk.
Who make you think you all of that, will then turn around and sign your death warrant.
Yes. Jonah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Jonah.
And so Isaiah says, God, I messed up.
Yes, God.
I dare not brag about who I am in your presence. See, that's why you have to come down off your horse. Because in God's presence, if you stay on your horse, God can't do nothing for you.
That's right.
Because you think it's all about you.
Uh-huh.
Amen. That's right.
Glory to God.
I thank God for the man of God that I have here.
Amen.
Because we're